first Canadarm was a series of robotic arms that were used on the space shuttle to deploy and move cargo, position astronauts, repair satellites, and maintain equipment. It could lift over 7,000 pounds of payload and place it on any position within 5 centimeters of a desired target. It was launched on November 13, 1981, and was retired on July 2011, along with the space shuttle program. It is now on display at the Canada Aviation and Space Museum in Ottawa, Ontario, Canada. Canadarm 2 was launched on April 19, 2001, aboard the space shuttle Endeavour. 3 days later, astronauts Chris Hadfield and Scott Brzezinski attached a robotic arm to the International Space Station. It is a bigger, much more advanced version of the first Canadarm and has 7 motorized joints. It can be controlled by astronauts on board the ISS, but can also be operated by the ground team at the Canadian Space Agency, or NASA. It works independently or with Dextre, the Canadian robotic repairman, to maintain the ISS. Dextre is the third robotic arm used by the ISS. It is a two-arm space robot that can be operated from Earth, performing tasks while the crew sleeps. Each arm is like a shortened Canadarm, moving one arm at a time. Dextre is used to carry orbital replacement units to and from work sites and install them when failures occur. It can also be seen on Canada's $5 bill. Canadarm 1 was used to release the Hubble Space Telescope and later to retrieve it when it needed repairs. A series of 4 servicing missions totaling an 18 spacewalks and over 129 hours were performed with the help of the Canadarm. This allowed astronauts to upgrade the telescope with better cameras and instruments, improving Hubble's view of the cosmos. Astronauts did the repairs by standing on platforms attached to the ends of the arms. Since the Canadarms were launched, Canadian spaceflight has achieved a few milestones. The first Canadian woman in space, the first Canadian to visit the ISS, the first to operate the Canadarm, the first Canadian to do a spacewalk, and the first Canadian commander of the station. Thanks for watching, and keep looking up.